Take three couples.
No, and Dad.
Who love to entertain.
And people, eh?
Ask each pair to throw a dinner party.
It's a thing to wake the taste buds up.
Tastes like salted peanut butter.
And get them to score each other in secret.
Oh, Lord, it's too late to do it like that.
Today, there's unbridled passion.
We got a tropical love thing going.
I know, right?
It's like just over the top, really.
And understated love.
Get that, Jim.
I was with Lauren 24/7. We'd probably strangle each other.
As they all compete to win a £1,000 prize.
Oh my God, what have we stepped into?
Today on Couples Come Dine With Me, we're in Birmingham, recently revealed as the UK's fastest-growing Valentine's destination. And soaking up those romantic vibes are first hosts and married couple of 20 years, Helen and Lorne.
Lorne! Are you doing ballet or are you taking Ethan?
I think I'd probably... Where's ballet? Where?
Some of our friends said we are the least likely couple that they think would get divorced because we couldn't be bothered.
Who said romance was dead? At least after two children and decades of married life, they must know each other inside out.
She told me a few things that I should say, just to be spontaneous. She's adventurous, stylish, clever, intelligent and beautiful.
How heartfelt.
How many?
You can chop the onions and I am going to...
How many?
Do four, actually, because they were slightly smaller than I thought they were.
The onions are for tonight's main course of lamb shanks in dark ale with creamy potatoes and shredded sprouts.
I'll have a bite to be polite. And if I don't like it...
You be polite. That'd be interesting.
Our second couple are engaged gym bunnies and love's young dream, well, according to them at least, Kieran and Anita.
We are shamelessly in love and we're not afraid to tell the world. It's not just your everyday puppy love where people goes, oh yeah, we're in love, I love him, I love her. It's like grown people love. It's not just what you see.
We're a part of each other.
Exactly.
Anyone got a bucket?
We've got a big thing about physical contact. Mm-hmm. So we're always like holding on to each other and things like that. And one thing is just like resting our cheeks together.
Oh yeah.
Right.
We're not really very tactile, are we?
No, not so, really.
Not in public, especially not in public.
Lorne mixes together those chopped onions with Worcestershire sauce and ketchup, while Helen measures out the dark ale.
Unfortunately, I'm not much of a barmaid.
The lamb shanks then go in along with vegetable stock, and the pot is left to slow cook.
Okay, I'm going to leave that for 3 hours now.
Next up for Helen and Lorne, their starter, celery and cashew soup.
I wouldn't usually order the soup in the restaurant when I'm going out. I never would order the soup in the restaurant.
No.
But the fact is, celery and cashew, I'm a bit intrigued.
The third and final couple are Rob and his Lithuanian beauty therapist wife, Agla.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, good luck.
Bring it on.
I am a bit more competitive.
Feeling more aggressive than competitive, to be honest.
Rob said, well, as long as we're going to have a nice time, you know, and enjoy. I said, I don't care about nice time and enjoy. I want to win.
When it comes to Agla, Rob can't quite believe his luck.
We all had it when we were teenagers walking down the street thinking, how's he pulled her? Absolute honour to be that guy now and people to think that about me. I love it.
Yes! That moment in life you need to cherish.
Look at Helen and Lorne's, it's all go with the soup.
We've gone for this recipe because we cooked it before for some friends and they really enjoyed it. So we thought we'd try again. It worked really well.
Lorne pours in vegetable stock to the chopped celery, then adds crushed cashew nuts.
It looks terrible because of the pasty cashew nuts. It's going to taste great.
If you're sure.
Can cashew make soup?
Cashews, well, you can just add them into the mix and stuff, can't you? But celery I'm not too keen on.
Celery cooked, it's blended to lose its stringiness.
Does it need more liquid? No!
No, but it does need a lid. Once blended, it's then passed through a sieve. That looks like quite a job.
you just end up with a really, really smooth...
Hopefully, small amount.
That's a relief. Soup done, just dessert to go. Lorne's in charge of baking a lemon and lime tart.
Quite happy with lemon and lime.
No, it's citrus based.
Yeah.
It's very cleansing at the end of it, so if you get...
If it's not too heavy, maybe...
Yeah, if it follows well.
Well, it's not a funny combination, it's just not...
Well,
not
yes, it is.
Kind of...
It's too bitter stuff. Like, what?
Lorne starts by zesting and juicing lemons and limes, while underling Helen beats some eggs.
Is that OK?
No, quite a lot. Because otherwise... OK,
no, the white, I'm asking. The that's right, cooks. If you want to do it, I'm just...
Eggs finally beaten to Lorne's satisfaction. They're mixed in with the fruit juices, sugar and cream.
Good. Never in doubt.
Happy with the filling, it's poured into a pastry base Lorne made earlier and it's ready to bake.
Yep, pudding's done.
Fruit prepped. Helen and Lorne freshen up in time to meet their first guests. Lovebirds, Kieran and Anita.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Nice to meet you. Do come in. I'm Helen.
Thank you. Hi. I'm Anita.
Hello, Anita. Nice. Hi. You. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Kieran.
Hi, Kieran. Hi. Nice to meet you. Do go through. Can I get you a drink?
A hot drink, please.
A hot drink, yeah. Tea, coffee?
No. Hot chocolate?
Hot chocolate, yeah. Got hot Thank chocolate. You.
Interesting choice.
Okay. Anita and Kieran. Yeah. She wants a hot drink. She'd like a hot chocolate. Hmm?
Hot chocolate?
Hot chocolate. Oh,
okay. That's left field, isn't it?
It is. This is Lorne.
Hi there.
Anita. Yeah. Hot chocolate. Maybe it's water, yes. Not milk. Hi there. So I hope that's okay.
Hi there.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Oh. Oh, mind that hot chocolate. Next to ring are Rob and Agler.
Hello, come in. Do come in. Helen, hi.
Hi, nice. Agler, nice to meet you.
Agler, yes. Lovely to meet you.
You've travelled from far?
It's not too far, no. Really. Is it? How about you guys?
A little bit of a travel.
Yeah, not too bad, yeah. But it's
what's your
to traffic.
Lithuania. Yeah.
Where the hell is that?
Charming. Coming up.
Looks like porridge.
Manners.
Straight talking.
I don't think Anita engages before she speaks.
And the language of love.
Normally we're always trying to be in contact with each other, pressing our faces against each other and things like this.
I think they're quite cheesy, really.
It's night one in Birmingham, and Helen and Lorne are the first couple to host a dinner party in the quest to win the £1,000 prize.
Cheers.
Cheers.
And while they check on their starter, Rob and Agler poke around upstairs.
What's that?
It's a puppy.
Oh, my God, that's scary. I don't want to...
It's like Chucky.
I don't want to touch it.
I hear you're a beautician. Can you help me?
Don't do miracles. I'm sorry.
She's talking about the doll, of course.
Is that a child would look like?
Well, not with me, wouldn't.
Back in the kitchen, Lorne has come up with a natty way to dress up that beige starter.
Are you not going to put celery leaves on top, are you?
Yeah.
No.
Just chopped up finely on
no.
top.
No. No, because I think that would just make it taste really weird. We didn't do that before.
So they're going down the waste disposal?
Yes.
There's a good boy.
See ya.
Well, I just think if somebody doesn't like celery, that is
what... Well, they've got celery soup.
I know, but it doesn't look like celery, does it?
Yeah, but it's called celery.
Quit squabbling and just serve up celery and cashew soup.
Would anybody like butter with their rolls?
Oh, God, yes.
Yes, Lorne.
Please.
You know what I mean.
Manners.
I don't think Anita engages before she speaks, and I think it's not... to be rude or anything. I think it's just a naturally says what she thinks.
Looks like porridge.
Hopefully it doesn't taste like porridge. I was a bit slightly offended by that because I do quite like porridge, but I don't think I don't think it looked like porridge. I mean, I love porridge.
That's good to know.
Basically it is celery, cashew nuts.
Salt. That's pretty much it.
Salt, pepper. It is quite simple.
I'd say there's a little bit too much salt for me.
It's just, you know, just a pinch of salt, really. So, because we don't eat a lot of salt at all. So,
that's a big pinch. I did enjoy it-ish,
but it was just too salty for me.
It tasted like salty peanut butter, if you want my honest opinion.
Mm. It was alright.
You like salt.
I do like salt.
Perhaps we should just change the subject.
Let's guess what we do
what
for
we
living.
What we do for living? Mm-hmm. Banker, maybe?
No.
Teacher?
I wish.
No. I think all my clues will give away, really, wouldn't it?
That's fine.
That's how we met.
Gives it away. Yeah, so we met. And we met each other. Yeah.
Immigration.
Oh, that's controversial.
Trying to ban me from the country.
Well, you said how you met
him. I charmed him and he married me now.
To be fair, I found it quite funny. It didn't. I wasn't offended by it.
Neither was I.
It made sense in my mind, anyway.
No, it was. I will agree. It was a beautiful moment, right?
Well, might as well tell them.
It's recruitment.
I don't work for him anymore, so it's going to be different now.
Is he doing the boss
now? I work for her.
That's progress for you.
Rob and Angler, I think they're fantastic.
Rob's
funny. I love them. Yeah, I could imagine hanging out with them. Things we do together. Without giving it away, you see.
Michael Bolton impersonator.
Think fashion and photography and stuff like that. That should give it away.
Ah, I think you models.
Models?
Give it away.
Yeah, we both model, but not just model. We train models. We organise fashion shows and things like that.
Impressed, Helen?
Oh, I think someone has to model balaclavas, don't they? It's got nice hands.
Moving swiftly on to the main course.
It smells really good.
Probably too salty, though.
Ooh. I hope it's not.
Oh, this is actually falling to bits, this one, Lauren.
The meat's just been in.
It's been in too long.
It's been in a little bit long.
Well, you best serve it quickly, then. Lamb shanks with creamy potatoes and shredded sprouts.
What's this? I know what that is, but what's this?
This is a combination of cheese and potato, basically. Very simple.
The lamb I loved. I thought that was gorgeous, beautiful, so tender, just falling off the bone.
Usually, if I do a lamb, I like to have, the bistro gravy on, not just within its own gravy. So I found that a bit boring.
Lamb shank, I thought it was falling off the bone, but it was very bland. There was no seasoning. Didn't blow me away. I have had better.
So Helen and Lorne can't seem to get their salt levels right, but at least their long marriage is impressing.
We all want to know what's the key to a long, happy relationship.
We do a lot of things sexually. Our friends actually say we are the couple that are least likely to get divorced because we just wouldn't be bothered. We just...
I was just about to say, that's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just that in a way that's actually a compliment. That we're actually, really happy.
Instead of always arguing and saying, that's it, divorce tomorrow.
Yeah.
They're a nice couple.
They are nice people, but they need to find that spark again, you know?
Oh, you want to like, be matchmaker.
Next!
But normally, we're always trying to be in contact with each other and things like that, pressing our faces against each other and things like this.
Yeah, it's a bit weird, isn't it?
We're almost becoming one person. We don't argue. Do we? No.
Literally, so how long have you been together?
4 and a bit years.
Yeah. I think they're quite cheesy, really. It's like just over the top, really.
If I was with Lorne 24/7, we'd probably strangle each other. Because you can't... You've got to have your own interests. You've got to have your own life.
Even if that involves talking to a freaky-looking doll.
Oh, there he comes. He's just a little old friend, and he sits upstairs. When somebody's walking past, I sort of go, I follow them like that. and then they go.
For me, I wouldn't like to be known as the house that had Chucky, and people know it as Chucky's house. I think I find that a bit strange myself personally. But
bye, Chucky.
Never want to see you again.
Last up, dessert.
Oh, wow.
Come on.
Now, that was quite impressive,
a little bit
actually.
Of faith.
Lorne's lemon and lime tart with a splodge of ice cream.
It's all homemade, the tart, pastry, everything?
Yep, not the ice cream, but everything else.
Yeah.
OK. Yep.
Lovely.
Not sure everyone agrees.
I didn't like it at all.
I didn't think so, you left
it. No, all I could taste was the egg. I had
For me, dessert was a pick of a bad bunch, you know, compared to the other two. I think that's why I liked it so much. I actually really enjoyed it.
We were happy with the meal we cooked, so we couldn't have done any differently.
Time to find out if maybe you should have. Scores out of 20, please.
I really enjoyed the night. Probably more so from the company than anything else.
What score you want to go? 6 out of 10.
6 out of 10. Because I think the warm people.
Food wasn't exactly my sort of thing, but it was a really enjoyable evening.
Ditto.
So we're going to give 14.
Hosting was good, but food was quite bland, so we're scoring 11. 11.
So Helen and Lorne failed to impress, scoring just 25 out of a possible 40. It's day two, and today it's the turn of tactile couple Kieran and Anita to host. And unsurprisingly, they're planning a night of passion and romance.
Our theme is chasing the miracle of love. You know, it's very rare that you find that true love, and we feel we found it, and we want to share with everyone else and help them look for it.
Oh, brace yourselves, everyone.
Kieran and Anita might struggle in the kitchen if obviously they can't be further than 6 inches apart. It might get a bit awkward, sort of moving around the kitchen.
Well, hopefully they can pry themselves apart long enough to cook, starting with the main, Anita's paradise curry.
Which doesn't really tell you anything, other than the fact that it is going to be a curry.
What type of sauce? I don't know. It's going to be some kind of special sauce.
Don't elaborate.
I often don't get a chance to cook, you know, Jamaican food, so I thought I want to introduce the other guests to my world.
And the curry she's hoping to introduce to the others contains goat, she thinks.
That's mutton, and what tastes so great about it is because it's a goat.
Pretty sure mutton comes from sheep, not goats. Anita adds a marinade, including curry powder and hot sauce, then gets a helping hand to mix it all together. Oh, look out.
Oh, I like the way you're doing that. Ooh. Hello. That's right, get it in there.
Oh, just leave him alone for a second. Goat massaged and marinated, it's ready for the pan.
So that's looking really good. I'm just going to keep adding water to it until it cooks for the next 3 to 4 hours.
And while that's stewing, Kieran and Anita nip out to get ingredients for their starter. Fruity beginnings!
I hope it's not fruit salad. Beginnings, what would you think that could be?
I'm scared.
Best cherries!
Best cherries, very sweet, just like you, dear.
How about the extra large kiwis? Very firm. Just like,
Anyway,
has anyone got a bucket of cold water?
If it was just a fruit salad, then that would be a bit poor, but I can't imagine it being that. Surely not. It's got to be better than just a fruit salad.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it. Even that might be a stretch. Back home, Kieran and Anita get to work preparing a fruit salad.
I guess it's not your typical dinner party starter, but it's tasty, it's healthy, gets the taste buds tanging, ready for everything else.
Not only we're cooking for them, we're looking out for their health as well.
Exactly. See how thoughtful we are?
So thoughtful, in fact, they're also planning to give a lesson in love to one couple in particular.
Helen and Lorne is a couple. I think they're great as a couple, but I think there's something missing there.
They just need to re-spark.
And hopefully tonight we can help them to do that.
Get them chasing the miracle of love again.
Exactly.
You lucky people! And for a final dollop of food love tonight, Kieran's making tarte au pomme plaisir.
Yeah, we'd like a bit of apple pie.
Yeah, I might just eat the pastry.
Too shy! For the tart filling, Kieran slices apples and adds sugar.
And that's 4 spoons of sugar. We're not all as sweet as you, dear.
Ain't that the truth?
The apples are then cooked while Kieran rolls out homemade pastry.
That's more fruit as well.
Yeah.
So we've got obviously fruit at the start and then in the dessert.
So we're going to definitely get a 1 of 5 a day today.
Apples softened, they're poured into the pastry case and the tart goes into the oven for half an hour. While it bakes, Kieran and Anita spruce themselves up, ready for the night ahead.
There's no competition. Oh. I'm very confident.
We'll see. Yeah.
And clearly prepared for tonight's love fest are first guests Rob and Agla.
Hello. Hi. Come in, come in.
Hello.
Good evening.
Welcome.
How are you?
Nice to see you. I'm great.
Loving the red.
Red seems to be the theme.
Last to arrive at the altar of love are sacrificial lambs Helen and Lorne.
Hello. Come in, welcome
to
our humble abode.
Rather you than me. Lovebirds assembled. Kieran has an announcement to make.
We're all out there chasing miracles, and love is probably the biggest miracle of all. Ourselves, we feel we've found true love between us, haven't we, baby? And we wish everyone else to find it, so that is why we are chasing the miracle of love tonight.
Well, good luck with that, everyone.
Kieran's speech, for me, I appreciate the finding love. It's just a little bit too much. I do find it a little bit cheesy.
And another one. Coming up, touchy subjects.
Just be with each other. Okay.
I'm not going to hold hands with somebody who wants me to hold hands.
And emotional moments.
It was too set up.
It's almost felt like it's going to be like Kumbaya moment.
It's night two, and Kieran and Anita are hosting an evening dedicated to love and romance.
Cheers!
And while they sort out their fruity starter...
We got a tropical love thing going.
I know, right?
The others grab the chance to escape them. I mean, inspect their host's modelling portfolio.
Can't see any family pictures.
No, they've... That's quite...
They're beautiful, though.
They just seem to be generally of them. Which is, and we've got loads of pictures in our house, but they're not mainly of us.
I mean, look at his physique. I don't mind having that myself, to be fair. But I want to know.
Just a little bit of self-indulgent, isn't it? Just a little bit.
A little bit.
I think so, but to be fair, if I had a six-pack, I'd have it out as well.
How do you feel about your nice feet?
It's just a little bit too, icky, sicky. Lovely.
Too much.
Yeah, it's a bit too much.
Just wait till you see the table.
Oh, it's beautiful. They've got heart-shaped napkins, they've got heart-shaped placemats, heart-shaped chocolates, rose petals, everything. What are they missing?
Place in your heart.
It's also missing some food, although I'm not sure they're going to get much of that with this starter. Fruity beginnings.
I know it's a little unorthodox having fruit salad kind of thing as a starter, but it's a thing to wake the taste buds up. That's the thing. And all it is the fruit and the fruit juice and some specially sourced passion fruit, especially for the passionate evening.
Not sure they're feeling it yet, however you try and sell it, Kieran.
It was like a breakfast, not as a starter.
Not acceptable, as far as I'm concerned, at all.
Even if you eat healthily, to say that fruit and that's all you're allowed to eat, that's just ridiculous. It's just ridiculous.
Yeah, but just think, you could get a six-pack like Kieran.
So how much modelling do you guys do, then?
From time to time, you might have seen a few things around.
Yeah. A few?
Do the photos get touched up at all, or do you actually have a six-pack?
We might need the evidence.
I'm not shy in showing off my body. Yes, I do have a six-pack. It wouldn't surprise me if someone ends up saying, they've got pictures of themselves everywhere, they love themselves or something.
Why would they say that?
I don't know, maybe he's aware of, how big his ego is. I'm sure he is, but it's overwhelming.
I do one sit-up a day. You get up in the morning and when you lie back down at night.
I would like to have a six-pack.
You have in the fridge.
And it looks like Helen's not interested in the six-pack diet either.
It could be a bit too much fruit.
It doesn't really go with wine that well. It's making a little bit sweet. So, sorry.
Helen seems very...
Standoffish
today. So I think that's what we've got to do. We've got to sort of work on her, as it were.
Well, a good start would be giving her something she actually wants to eat. So fingers crossed for your curry. Shame you're not sure what's in it.
Mutton is goat. Apparently, somebody says it's not.
Mutton in English is lamb.
Maybe in Birmingham. Anyway, here it is, Anita's Paradise Curry with rice and peas.
So, guys, is this mutton or goat?
This is goat, but in the Caribbean.
But they call it mutton in the Caribbean. Yeah, that's the confusing part, you see.
Okay.
But mind you, we say this is rice and peas. It's actually rice and kidney beans.
I was going to say that, actually, yeah. So it's not...
I always heard the phrase, mutton dressed as lamb. But I never heard the phrase, mutton dressed as goat.
So... What was it? I'm confused. What was it, goat?
I don't know.
Turns out it was goat.
I thought the main course was good.
The mutton, goat mutton, was lovely, the bit that I had.
The main course seems to have got Helen back on side, now to crank up the charm offensive.
What's the most romantic thing you've done for each other?
We don't really do demonstrative romance.
No, I'm not.
We're not. Lawrence doesn't buy flowers. His mum was a florist. She knows, he knows how much they cost. He hardly ever buys flowers. I'm not that bothered.
Flowers die.
You old romantics, you. But at least they're managing to get Helen to open up.
When he actually proposed, I was in the bath. I'd had a really awful day at work, and I was just lying there, and he just like came and sat by, and he went.
So I think Operation Helen went pretty well.
I think it went pretty well.
You know, we got her talking. She was coming out of herself more. She had adding a lot to the conversation.
Yeah.
So all in all, successful, I think.
Yeah, maybe you've won her over. Oh, hello. What's this? Romantic serenading. Oh, dear, this doesn't bode well.
Now, what I want everyone to do is to listen carefully to the lyrics and that and look at each other. While we're singing, just be with each other, okay?
What do you mean? Holding hands and be into each other.
In the moment together.
Do we have to?
Yeah, put the wine down.
Put the wine down.
Well, just do one hand.
You get that, Jim?
Come on, just get it over with.
Last first met, there was something electric.
He's singing!
You caught my heart with your beautiful smile. I tried to be cool, I wanted to be slick. So I asked if we could just talk for a while.
Lorne and I do not do holding hands. I'm not going to hold hands with somebody who wants me to hold hands. I don't need to hold Lorne's hand.
Now that I've found you...
You are holding it!
Go on, keeping you here, close to my heart.
When Anita started crying, that was their bubble. And we were just looking in.
The whole thing should have been much more natural instead of a set-up. It was too set-up.
It's almost felt like it's going to be like Kumbaya moment.
Has anyone got a tissue?
I think all in all, our theme, it's gone the way we wanted it to. Maybe the people that we really wanted to affect, we didn't really. They kind of rebelled. Yeah. Not so much Lorne, but Helen particularly.
Maybe you should just concentrate on dessert instead.
It smells really good.
The last course is a slice of love pie with a fancy French name.
Can I hear the pronunciation as it was on the menu?
It is tarte aux pommes plaisir, which is just French for apple pie delight.
So why are you going for French influence?
Because it's love. French signifies love, you see.
That's nice.
Pretty soggy love by the look of it.
So yeah, after all this dessert, can we still keep your six-pack? We need evidence. Just need to see it's real.
It didn't take much persuading.
Let's see. I just hope I didn't bloat out too much.
Yeah, that's rubbish. You should see mine.
Happy? A little clap? What I say? Let's go home, darling. I did think his photos were touched up. Clearly they weren't. So Kieran proved that real photos.
I've got a six-pack in the fridge.
Stop nicking your wife's jokes.
The apple pie was okay, but I never have single cream on anything because I just don't like single cream. So the fact that it was single cream being poured over it basically ruined the dessert for me.
Apple puree I actually quite enjoyed. I didn't like the pastry. For me, it was too thick and chewy. It was quite chewy for me.
Not a lot we would have changed, so just fingers crossed that
fingers
we get some
and everything.
Good scores, yes.
You might need more than crossed fingers.
We've got 20 points, so let's divide it up into sections. We've got 4 points for the...
Oh, Lord, it's too late to do it like that.
She's not wrong.
I'll give her 13.
Myself, to be fair, I think it's kind of was the same, equal nights. Only the love thing for me, so I would give them 12.
The food I thought was a little bit basic. The love thing was completely over the top. So tonight we're going to give them a 12.
Tonight we're going to score Kieran and Anita a 12.
So the power of Kieran and Anita's love fails to win over hearts and minds, earning them just 24 points. Not that they seem particularly bothered. Oh, this is slightly awkward. It's the final day in Birmingham. And today's hosts, Rob and Agla, are still feeling the after effects of last night.
Anita and Kieran just pushed this love thing way too much. I think Helen and Lorne were a little bit uncomfortable.
A little bit?
Yeah, it was, as I suspected it might be, so...
But it was even more intense than I would have imagined. I think it would be nice not to have any love instruction tonight.
Well, you're in luck. A confident Agla plans to let the grub do the talking.
I definitely think Lithuanian food can win, especially judging on what we had so far. We're going to try to introduce them into different type of foods, maybe more sophisticated type of menu.
I don't think I've ever had Lithuanian...
Don't even know what Lithuanian food's like.
Well, try this for size, then. Tonight's starter is Grasinos Vista, or stuffed chicken legs with salad.
That's my kind of thing. Chicken and salad, that's exactly my kind of thing, that is.
Where you put the stuffing in a chicken leg? Because it's... unless you have it...
Take the bone out.
Yep, that's exactly right, and Agla's in charge.
Rob, I'm going to take skins off. What I need you to do, you're going to separate the meat from the bone, so just get rid of the bone.
OK.
Basically, yeah?
I think Agla might well be the boss in the kitchen.
Yeah, I can imagine her doing the cooking, telling Rob, oh, do that and do that and do that.
Have you used one of those before, darling?
I haven't, no.
You haven't?
I didn't know we had it.
Having become acquainted with the mincer, Rob gets to work on the chicken while Agla grates carrots.
This is hard work.
Should have gone for soup.
Yeah, oh no. Oh, just fruit. In the bowl.
Oh, now. The carrots go into the minced chicken along with chopped dates.
They add a little bit more colour and also a little bit sweetness.
The mix is then stuffed back into the chicken skins.
So you can start stuffing as well.
I'd rather not get involved with it.
He doesn't dare. The stuffed chicken legs then go into the oven and they'll actually be served cold.
So now it's your turn, darling.
Rob's going to be overseeing dessert, chocolate fruit bowls with jellied oranges.
I don't think orange and chocolate goes well together. For me, I don't, actually.
I know what you mean.
I see that.
I'm not a big chocolate orange fan, but I bet it's still going to be nice.
Maybe the bowl is actually made of chocolate. They might be doing a little mould.
Hello, what's going on here?
Well done.
This isn't the time for messing about.
You try that one.
I can't do it. So once we blow up the balloons, we're going to dip it into melt chocolate right at the bottom of the balloon to create that bowl shape.
Ah, clever! Balloons finally inflated, Rob melts milk chocolate and gets dipping.
Moment of truth. Yeah, don't squeeze it, yeah. Perfect, well done, darling. My turn.
While the chocolate-coated balloons are left to set, it's on to the jellied oranges. Rob makes the jelly by warming together pomegranate juice, gelatin and mango coulis.
It's more or less a case of I've done this bit. If it doesn't set, then it's...
your responsibility?
Yeah.
Well, here goes.
Looking well. Hopefully it sets. Just, yeah. Last time it didn't set, so ruined it.
No pressure then, eh, Rob? Jelly setting, hopefully it's only the main course to go. Pan-fried sea bass with dauphinoise potatoes.
As long as it's that Dufanese isn't cheesy stuff, because I don't
What's
like
sea-bass?
Cheesy potatoes. Sea bass is fish. That's what I'm saying. It's,
okay.
It's a fish.
I might enjoy that.
I don't like the taste of fish. I don't like quite a lot of the texture of some of the slimier things. I just don't, and I don't eat anything from the sea.
No, I will try it. I'll definitely try it.
How very noble of you. After a check for bones, it's job done in the kitchen, as the fish won't be cooked until just before serving.
Viskas yra paruošta, šią makro laikas eiti ruoštis.
It's time to get ready.
Wow, Rob's Lithuanian's good. After a quick change of clothes, it's time to greet their first guests. Hoping for a night out of the spotlight, it's Helen and Lorn.
Hello! Come on in!
Thank you!
Kieran and Anita probably won't have any champagne, but we'll offer.
I've got hot chocolate.
Oh, yeah.
And talking of Anita, here she is. Ah, in sync as ever, with her beau, Kieran.
Hello! Come on in! How are you?
Nice to see you again.
Cheers.
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 Good evening.
God, I always have to be the odd one.
Yes. I have noticed.
I think we all have. Coming up!
If I sense that there's a couple who are not happy, then it plays on my mind.
Anita gets anxious.
She was worried that we were going through some sort of divorce, I think.
Agla's dreams are deflated.
It would have been such a perfect dessert.
And the winners are revealed. It's the last night of the couples competition in Birmingham, and Rob and Agla are the third and final pair to host. They're banking on a night of Anglo-Lithuanian fare to see them win the £1,000.
Final nine.
And after a traditional Baltic greeting ceremony...
Oh. You could be Lithuanian.
Rob and Agla get the starter ready.
Looking good. Just need to slice it.
While Helen and Lorne sneak off to get a snapshot of Agla's homeland.
So do you think that's the house? Do you think?
Well... It's really...
I mean, is it a little
very,
bit like
very
we've
realistic.
Got a shed at the bottom of the garden that looks very similar to that?
Yeah.
It's just like something out of the 1950s.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
But
and this is something out of the 1850s.
Well, it is, isn't it?
Back downstairs, the first course is ready. Nearly.
Oh, it's called by error.
One job, love.
Hair plucked, it's good to go. Grashinas Vista, or stuffed chicken legs.
It stands for Grashina is my auntie's name, and Vista is chicken. So, and obviously I got the recipe from my auntie, so I called it Grashinas Vista.
For our first sort of taste of Lithuanian
food,
and possibly only ever
Lithuanian food.
That was
it was unusual, maybe more complex than I had imagined.
Chicken and salad is of my favourite stuff, basically. That and fruit. So, yeah, big hit with me. That was
very good.
I feel very happy of introducing a little bit something of Lithuanian to them. And I think they seem to enjoy it as well. So, I'm very proud.
Having enjoyed a first taste of Lithuania, Helen wants to find out more about Agla's childhood home.
We imagine like there might be a small holding attached with like goats, chickens, that type of thing. Yeah.
You spot on, sir. You have been to Lithuania.
There's no running water.
Oh, wow.
So what do you do?
You have got some water from that well?
Yeah, I mean, I remember the first time I went, that really got me to understand Agra a lot more.
She left there at 18 and had no running
water. And even now when they go back, Rob goes, you know, they go to the well to get the water. It's something... It's not... that just doesn't happen in this country.
I remember it was in the summer and I went for the swim in this lake. And for me, it was quite strange in my head. I'll always remember someone saying this. Your dad was there as well with a bar of soap washing.
Wow!
He's brilliant, honestly.
I think Agla, she always kind of portrays a strong person and what have you. Hearing about how she grew up and things like that, it all kind of makes sense.
So far, so good for Robin Agler. Now for that tricky sea bass main.
We know that Lorne isn't a big fish fan. Hoping he'll try it.
After pan frying for 10 minutes, the sea bass is ready to serve, along with dauphinoise potatoes, beetroot, and a creamy white wine sauce.
Sorry, I know obviously you don't like fish too.
I don't eat it, but I'm gonna try it.
Thank you.
I'd eat fish every day.
Exactly. Mm. I would, but because he doesn't eat it, we hardly ever eat it.
Exactly. The texture of the fish was brilliant. It was very lovely, and the white sauce, that was beautiful.
And even Lorne is daring to give it a go.
He's actually eating a little bit of that, which is...
A little bit, I'm eating
loads. I do loads, don't they?
Do you like it?
So,
I'm going through a little bit of a thing at the moment when I can't actually taste very much, so...
Well, that's handy.
Yeah, I do have a problem with taste buds. It sort of comes and goes. And it gone tonight? Yeah, tonight. It didn't taste of anything. So it was, so
I'm
it was
not sure
fine
that's
a
compliment to the chef.
No, but
yeah.
For the fish went down really well because we were worried about Lorne beforehand and it wasn't a problem at all.
That's one problem sorted, but Anita's still got issues of her own.
If I sense that there's a couple who are not happy, then it plays on my mind. On our night, you know, I wanted us, you know, Kieran was singing to me and I didn't want you guys to feel left out. I wanted you guys to be holding hands, looking at each other, because that would be sort of your moment to be in your own, in but, each other's bubble. Yeah. But you refused to hold hands.
We did hold hands in the end, but it's a little bit forced, a little bit awkward, a little bit evangelical.
You are going to hold his hand.
Thrusting the love onto you.
Yeah. She, bizarrely, for me, was worried that we were going through some sort of divorce, I think, because we don't do this. And she was saying, you know, we wanted to try and make an ambience for you, but unfortunately they didn't realise that the ambience they were creating was actually just making us just go, oh my God, what have we stepped into?
I felt like there was something wrong there and I needed to fix that.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
It was actually quite sweet talking to her and finding out that, you know, she was actually trying to do something that she thought was out, because I think she thinks we need to relate.
What were your thoughts on these guys when they turned up?
How did they pull her?
No, we're still thinking.
When people turn around and they go, how do you guys meet? We always used to say as a joke, RussianWives.com. And no one ever questioned it. No one.
We had a little laugh about Rob boxing above his weight, and I think he has done very well for himself there. Yeah.
Rob probably gets told that all the time.
Not really, no, I'm handsome. It took me by surprise. I thought I'd laugh it off. It upset me, really.
Oh, right, sorry. Last up is dessert, and having sliced up the jellied oranges...
Well, this set really well.
It's all right, yeah?
Yeah, orange and jelly.
The final challenge is the chocolate bowls. Oh, that doesn't look right.
Oh, man. I'm good. It's actually melted, so it would have been such a perfect dessert.
And it was all going so well. Having tried to cover up the damage with eat and miss, Rob and Agla's chances of winning the £1,000 are still looking somewhat shriveled.
I hope they will appreciate the effort and realise what this should have been look like.
Yeah.
Well, I reckon you just about get the idea. Chocolate fruit plate, sorry, bowl with jellied oranges.
First to say, the chocolate bowls actually should have looked a bit better.
Yeah. Don't think you'd expect a perfect bowl made of chocolate.
Well, that's very understanding.
Yeah. Food and then eating the plate.
Ooh, dessert. Ooh, that was just my kind of thing. Now, there was fruit, healthy, yes, but with the added sweetness of the chocolate itself. Oh.
I think the fact that it was a lot more of an eat and mess rather than just fruiting it, so there's a bit of effort gone into there.
So you've got the homemade bowl, so there was a lot of work gone in. Yeah. It wasn't just
a chopped
bowl of fruit.
Went down better than what I expected, because obviously it has gone wrong, it's but really they good. Enjoyed much more than we expected.
Yeah.
Cheers, it's been lovely. I think it's risky to say, but if I may,
You're looking at the winners.
Yeah.
Confident, eh? Time to find out if all that bravado is justified. They need 26 points to grab the grand from Helen and Lorne.
I would have thought 8 or 9, to be honest, in fairness, to be honest.
I don't know if I'm being a bit mean with an 8. Which we go?
17, 18, I would have thought.
I'd go pretty high, 8 or 9, because I thought it was a fantastic night.
In general, the whole night, I would say 8.
That would be 16 or 17.
Yeah.
Or 20.
Yeah.
Which one are we going for?
Tonight we're going to give Jobnagler 18.
After a little debate, we're going to give Agler and Rob 17.
The scoring is done in secret, and it's up to tonight's host to announce the winners.
So, in third place, Kieran and Anita. Congratulations! Second place, Lorne and Helen. First place, Rob and Agla. Two good friends.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, no, they did a really amazing job.
No, I think overall, the right person won.
We may not have won, but we still got each other.
Yeah, we've already won.
Mm-hmm.
And off they go again. I hope you're watching Helen and Lorne. Oh, well, at least he tried.
Cheers, guys.
For more on Come Dine With Me, head to the Channel 4 website. On the wings of love,
up and above the clouds. Don't throw out your old jeans. There's still life in them yet. This old thing, the Vintage Clothes Show, proves how tonight at 8 on 4. Next up, The Simpsons. Two of us together flying high.